Yo, Remo.
What's up, bro?
Today's Sunday. You have to get up and record.
All right, man. I'll get to it in a little bit. As soon as the game is finished.
We don't have a little bit.
So you want me to do it right now?
Yes, I need to get your ass up and go with the cereal.
Wow.
Wow. All right, you know what? I don't want no problems. I'm going to get up. What's going on? It's Remo, aka Mr. Rich Threads, back at you with another one of Let's Talk Fashion, powered by the JBT Network. And yes, we are back for another week of talking fashion, sports, entertainment, society, culture. We intertwined it all in one. But what's new this week? Yeah, we got merch. Should I show you the backside? You'll see that later. But let's jump right into it, man. This week's episode is based around some plus size love. We don't call it plus size because, you know, plus size gets a little jaded, gets a little emotional. People don't be really liking the sound of plus size. So we calling it plush size. Plush size, I mean P-L-U-S-H, where, you know, they might not be the smalls, the mediums, maybe not quite a large, but we have fun with fashion over here. And there's no rules when it comes to this. You know, most times when people say plus size, they think, oh, the big people, fat, obese, whatever the case is. But you might be a little bit more curvish than some. You might have a little bit more muscles than some. You might be just a bigger individual, whether you're 6'6", 280, whatever it might be. But in your mind, don't disrespect me and call me a plus size model. I get it. So we're going to know as plush size this week. And I want to highlight a few people in history that have been known as being on the plush size, whatever you want to label it as. And let's start off with Missy Elliot. Missy Elliot is a staple in the hip hop community for all her antics when it comes to dancing, when it comes to fashion, when it comes to music in general. But you know for a fact, when you seen Missy back in the day, she was putting them looks together and it was in a very unique way. And it was kind of before her time where today you might see people with the outlandish looks and people looking real different per se. But Missy, she stayed in her lane and she made it work for her. Whether you know her for the colorful suits, the big puffy suits, the finger waves, big glasses. She did it all in her lane and she made it work for herself to the point where it's like, yo, damn. Missy really held the candle light for everybody who wasn't the Coke-shaped model girl, but she did her thing, and she was never disrespected when it came to creativity. And creativity is one of the elements in fashion that's kind of forgotten to these days, where people really don't try to be creative. They try to look like almost like mannequins, that uniform look. Everybody wants to look the same. Everybody wants to do the same thing and be the same, shot the same brands. We didn't even know certain brands that Missy was wearing, but she was putting it together to the point where she was respected in all facets of in her community, in our community. And once again, Missy is definitely one of them people who just was it. And you gotta tip your hat over to her, man. Another throwback entity when it came to fashion and the big people size, big boy, baby. Biggie Smalls, man. Biggie Smalls was definitely one of the flyest big guys that we've ever seen. Whether it be the Cool G's, whether it be Karl Kanai, whether it be the Versace drip, glasses. He kind of had like an eye issue, but we never seen it because he was stuck behind famous frames all the time, and he really put together them looks. And it becomes challenging to some. Like, yo, where he getting this stuff in that in size? When you are that and you're that fly, there's no questioning about where you got it from. It's just how you putting it on. And he, you know, in most cases, Big was just known as that God, man. And, you know, unfortunately, his time was really cut short on the earth. But up to today, you could say, like, yo, Biggie's always been known for being that guy when it comes to big boy fashion. You could say other people like, you know, Fat Joe, Heavy D, that realm of, you know, area of Big Boy Fashion. But I would have to put Biggie Smalls somewhere up there because, you know, the Puff era wasn't the Puff era without Biggie Smalls, man. For real, for real. And me personally, being a New Yorker, we knew Biggie as, you know, the fly big guy. And I don't think anybody else would question it. I haven't seen him on an off day, especially when you're getting money. When you're getting money, you got to look like you're getting money. Rolexes was always, you know, along with fashion goes accessories. And he played with every facet of fashion when it came to, you know, being seen, being emulized. And up to today, you know, the Coogi look was known as the Biggie look. So definitely salute to Biggie Smalls. Let's get a little bit more modern when it comes to plush size fashion. And, you know, I would like to highlight Lizzo. You know, sometimes she gets caught up with, you know, some of the outfits that's a little bit raunchy, you know. But, you know, sometimes viral moments are needed and, you know, to build their character. But we've also seen her in clean cut outfits and real fashionable dresses and being seen in the light of class. And it's real hard to sometimes for people to really feel comfortable in that lane. And I think she's done it at the highest level, especially during the modern era where, you know, a certain body type is emulated because, you know, the BBL culture, which makes it a little bit harder for her. But she really pulls it off in a way where it's like, you know, it's classy and we want to big her up for sure. And when we talk about modern fly, flashy, plush size, let's go with the man name is the biggest boss, Rick Ross. Rick Ross, you know, he's on his weight journey, changing his physique. But Rick Ross is also another dude who grew up in the modern time when it comes to being in the fashion lane, whether it be hip hop, whether it be in business, and he's never looked like he's been out of place. You know, he was really a heavy set dude to the point where it was like, all right, bro, put your shirt on. But he's never felt uncomfortable in any situation to the point where he's done the Versace. He's done the Louis. He's done it all. And please believe it, he's probably top five ever big dudes that dress because of, one, the confidence, and two, just the way to he presents it all in a bundle where it keeps going. And I do nothing but appreciate somebody with such confidence like Rick Ross does, man. He really puts his looks together. And why not, man? Rick Ross, definitely salute you, man. We appreciate everything you do in the space of hip-hop, fashion, business, moguls. Keep on doing what you're doing, bro. We definitely appreciate you. I would like to give one honorable mention to my man Fat Joe. Fat Joe has been big his whole life, but he's working this. He's also working on, you know, his size and, you know, when it comes to health and all of that. But definitely Fat Joe has been fly for a long time, and he grew up and he's been famous since the Biggie Smalls era to the current era where, you know, he's really a sneakerhead first. But when it comes to putting together looks, he's always been on the forefront of that. I've never seen him outshine by anybody that got muscles or anything like that. And that's pure confidence and that's pure longevity in the game where knowing sometimes you got to switch it up. I know sometimes dudes grew up in the 90s and they really can't get down with the tight pants era. They really can't get with the switching and the lanes that things are really going in the modern way. But he's navigated himself to the current era. And Fat Joe, honorable mention. We definitely appreciate you, your contribution to hip hop, and we'll be right back with some more conversation about fashion, sports, hip hop, and it all. We'll be back. Welcome back. We got a special guest in the building, my man Colby.
Fashion.
What's going on?
Man, what fashion, my guy? How you feeling today?
I'm cooling, man. It's a beautiful day outside. Getting the cars washed. About to later on be our little car show.
Nice. Listen, man. We brought you about. We don't even usually say plus size, but we're not doing plus size. We call it plush size.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because we're body shame over here. Being that, you know, I had to bring you on because, you know, I get a little backstory. So, you family one of my homies for everybody wearing. And I used to look at this dude. I'm like, nigga trying to take my lay? Like, you know, when it comes to big boy fashion, you know, I lost a lot of weight, but I'm like, yo, he really doing it. Like, allow me. Like, what's up with him? Nobody talk to this guy. Like, this is my lane, you know? So basically, like, I always appreciated what you did in the fashion space, so it'd only be right that I have you on this EP, you feel me? So let's jump right into it, man. When it comes to, let's say, plush size fashion, what are some of the challenges when it comes to, like, finding fits? Because, you know, we don't do outfits, we do pieces. So when it comes to that, what challenges comes with that when it comes to, like, shopping and, you know, putting together looks?
I mean, I think the biggest challenge for us dudes, you know, that are of size would definitely be, like, jeans and or shirts. Because most of the stuff that's made now is all European. It's made for for slim folks out there. Man, a lot of these clothes, like, for instance, let's say H&M, all this shit is European. You know what I'm saying? What's another brand? H&M, you know, like Saks. Some of those places, man, they're all for the plus size guys.
So I used to have difficulty in finding good jeans as well, because, you know, sometimes when it comes to bigger sizes, they kind of do a reduction in the quality of pants. You know what I'm saying? And then some of the looks, just like the modern, the edge, they kind of put a little bit of plastic in it. So you don't get that raw denim feel from a lot of these companies. So it's like, yo, what about us? Like, you know? So usually you replace the waist size and then you're like sacrificing the way that it fits on the bottom or the tightness of the ankle.
Or
you get that, I call it the tight angle fit, where it's like your calf show, you know, it's like, I couldn't do a lot of those looks. So what I usually did was I used bigger size, and I usually take it filler, and I used to get it downsized.
Okay.
You know, where it fit me to where I might be willing to wear either a boot or a sneaker, depending on the size of the shoe. So I get a little tail end of and give me that European type of feel to the affordable pair of jeans, you feel me?
I'm blessed, highly favored. 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 Every day I wake up and do my job. I'm on the private plane getting closer to God. Hit you with a jab, make you touch us live.
I come back.
Come to, like, Mauricio when it comes to, like, fashion. What was, like, kind of like your origin story when it came to, like, your inspiration in fashion?
So I'll keep it a complete honest. What inspired me for fashion was my mom's, honestly. It's my mom's. I always thought, like, the colors that she put together, the fits that she put together were always fire. So that was, like, my small inspiration for fashion. And as of, like, now, one person I do like in the fashion world, especially when it came to, like, fitted sneakers or, like, just different pieces, was, like, Action Bronson. That guy right there, he might dress a little out of the ordinary. But you gotta look at the certain pieces he put together, the sneakers that he wear, the fitters that he's wearing.
You know, I would say, like, you know, it's I don't respect a lot of big dudes fashion because I feel as though that they play into their size versus taking their time and really putting looks together. So they're waiting what's available versus hunting. And you say hunting, we saying like, you know, we might see a shirt that we don't have nothing to go with, but we not gonna wear it right away. We gonna wrong in it until we find an appropriate look for it, and then blah. For that.
It's funny you say that. Reason being, I actually have this. I ain't come out with it yet. I have this fire varsity jacket. I didn't even wear it yet, just because of that reason. Just for the reason that it's multicolored and it's just like
yeah. Figure something out. So you sleeping? You putting at the rest right now? Absolutely.
Exactly. Got to put it to rest until the right time.
So, wait, let's do me a solid, right?
Rest at the right time.
What was through getting ready with you, man? How does the fit usually come together? Like, do you go head to toe to head, start from the kicks? What was through it?
So, to be honest, for me, I don't put things together. If I see something I like, I'm going to go for it. And then later on down the line, I'll put it together. You know what I'm saying? Like I don't sit there and think about, I got these color pick kicks, what can I match with that? I just get pieces and I put it together. I don't think about what I'm buying. I just know
okay,
I like
all right,
that.
So stand
it's my size.
So stand right there. Now you got your pieces put together.
That's how I roll.
But now you're getting that call, like, yo, we got a car event coming up. This one is crazy. You gonna have all the little yays out there and all that. Time to get dressed. What was through it? How it works?
Yeah. Really and truly, I dress how I am right now.
Okay.
Like a nice little fire hoodie, some jeans, and I'm doing my beaters. You know what I'm saying? But at the same time, you're still gonna be like, damn, yeah, nah, that's fire. Like the beaters I have on, I keep it a buck. I got so many people that's like, damn, son, I had a pair of those, but I fucked them up.
Damn,
like, this is regular.
And so when we classify that you are a sneaker guy, when you say sneak, well, you just, you know, you just enamored with like sneakers and your thing.
I'm going to definitely say, I'm definitely a sneaker guy. Definitely sneaker and great. Definitely a fitting type of guy.
It's same.
You know what I'm saying? I put it this way. I honestly got to. I gotta go to IKEA later on.
I've had that before too.
I'm running out of space.
so is it safe to say you got the turtleneck and Chelsea boots, Bobby? Hello, I'm Kenny. Pardon? You're doing it there too.
Oh, of course. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Listen, I gotta pair some all those.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Gotta clean up. Gotta be able to clean. You know what?
Nice little
I would say.
Absolutely.
Shoot. A lot of like the bigger guys, it's hard for them to switch it up. Like, you know, in one lane, but like being the ability to be able to clean up well in that size is definitely a challenge. But when done right, it could be appreciated by everybody.
Yeah, you're right though, because I did have a moment where, you know, it was a challenge for me to, you know, let's say I'm going to a nice big fete, you know, it was one of those dress up fetes. It was kind of hard for me to find like a sport jacket that was gonna fit me right and also make me look good at the same time. You know what I'm saying? So like, I could totally understand that, but you know, it just takes time to figure out what your look is going to be
when you say
outside
fit,
of what you normally
everybody
wear.
Now West Indian.
Okay.
But you want to break what an actual fit is so they'll know. Like, what you put.
You break it down. In other words,
that's people, where that's made. Like, you see the moat popping in.
Big,
yeah.
Big potty. That listen, it'll be that
everybody,
one dude with the empty bottle 1942 in the crowd doing some shit. You know what I'm saying? That type of party.
Listen, stay, and it comes and it goes, just like money come right. and go. But that night, when they say fit, is you all in or you all out. So you with it. That's just how it go. Well, I one thing when it comes to like fits, I'm not a little white guy. I never been the all white guy. Like I, that just never been me.
Yeah, I'm the type where I might wear all black with some white, and that's my white.
Okay, a touch of white, but all white, definitely. But out my, that's not me at all. At all.
Not my vibe. Because you know what? What gets me upset about some people that go to all white parties is that you spend all that money for your all white fit for it to just get fucked up.
And never wear it again.
Yeah, like what?
And never wear it. That's crazy. Well, right. So being that, you know, you're around the age range, what would you say is your favorite era of fashion so far?
My favorite era of fashion. Favorite era of fashion would be like late 90s. Into where I was up into high school. Like, which was, high school was like 07 to like 2011. And I say that being because that's where I found my lane and like what type of fashion I like. I'm a streetwear kind of guy. I still wear, you know, Supreme, the Bay, you know, the Hundreds. The Hundreds. And Obey, plenty of other brands that not a lot of either people are looking at or just not a lot are just like interested in. Because everybody's interested in what? Foreign. Everybody's interested in some Armani jeans. Man, listen, you get the same quality in Armani jeans, go to G-Star. You feel me?
That was kind of been one of the dopest eras because of the size and the way things were like seen. Like, well, play for colors as well during that era of fashion, man. So I'm gonna push out. I see real quick, right?
Yeah.
If there's one thing with fashion right now that you wish could go away forever, what would that one thing be?
One thing in fashion I would want to go away. Everybody wearing the same shit. Tired of seeing Balenciagas on everybody's feet. Tired of seeing everybody wearing purple jeans. Tired of seeing, you know, I'm just tired of seeing everybody just wearing the same shit. Everybody just do your own style.
Yeah.
I'm tired of everybody, oh, this is the hottest thing out. I got to go get that. Nah, just bro, be yourself. Dress what comes to you. Don't dress because the next man is doing that. Oh, I got to go get that. Nah, that's not how fashion works. That's not how you should work. You know what I'm saying?
I think you know the actual like street fashion itself was a creative time, and we've lost some in that because I don't know whether it be TV, Instagram, everything is more accessible. But I think just people lost the factor of creativity. You know,
I think part of it is music, man. Like, you know, all these dudes talking about this, that, the other. They got, you know, people feel like they gotta go get that. They feel like, you know. Since they talked about it, oh, you know, I got to be the hottest person out there. I got to go get that.
Yeah. You know, I call it the depression era. Everybody wants to wear black.
Yeah.
And they wants to act like they're dirty all the time. No, you take a shower in the morning. I'm more like, like, present yourself in a manner where, you know, you it's more kind of ugly to see out. Like, these kids don't even cut their hair no more.
Nah, oh, my God. Look. I had to get the fresh.
I had to get it laid. That's how you see. But back in the day, it's like, you know, the first time we went to a barber, go get fresh.
Right.
That was the rep. And then we came home, we took a shower. A shower is an essential key.
The key is to be honest with yourself. We have to be honest with ourselves before we do anything.
So not feeling a certain way.
Exactly.
Especially West Indians. You got to bathe. Like you say, you got to go home and bathe.
It's crazy because I definitely work. I work in the school, right? And I ain't gonna front some of these kids. It's just like, yo, bro, you ain't showered before you got here? No? Okay. I thought it was just me. You feel me?
Definitely the musty era, man.
Oh, my God.
Definitely the musty era.
It be killing me sometimes, man. I walk past, like, let's say, like 10 of these kids, and just like, yo, bro, Your mother ain't tell you nothing in the morning? Like, what happened? Like, come on. Matter of fact, yo, here's some baby wipes. Go wipe your armpits. You know what I'm saying? Go to the bathroom with that.
Or the emergency get fresh pack, right?
Yeah, that's the emergency fries. Yo, bro, here, take some baby wipes.
Crazy. Yo, being that you said you went to the sneaky game, right?
Yeah.
What brought that about for you? Like what made you a sneaker guy? Well, dude, if you had one part or one time in life where it was like, yo, I really like it here, and I want to stay in the sneaker way.
I'm a resort back to my first answer, which was Mom Dukes. I still got my first pair of J's hanging in the car. You know, and ever since then, I've always liked J's.
Yeah.
Or just like, you know, something just different. And what made me like the era more was when Ronnie Flegg was dropping all the ASICs. Before Kith was Kith, it used to be called Atrium.
Ronnie
Flegg would drop all his ASICs, the Flamingos, all of them at Atrium. And every time I would go in there, bro, it used to just look like a colorful wall. So that right there, it made me, you know, like and appreciate a lot of more sneakers.
That's a solid, right? And, you know, like, being as you said, ASICs, because ASICs is like, kind of like known as a dad shoe now, but like,
yeah.
That era, the New Balance, Sauconys, that kind of like was a different time where like the lane and the trajectory of sneakers changed, where it wasn't just about wearing J's. Like, yeah. Jordan, you know, it's still cool today, but they're getting options and different fields, especially in New York, where New York was like, we were known as the fashion capital at one point in time. People in Atlanta, and people in Texas, and people LA were like, yo, what are they wearing in New York?
And it's funny you say that, because a lot of those states now, they starting to catch up.
I don't even know if it's catch up or just the influence of music has not been the New York lane. So it kind of like they took the mantle from us and kind of made it their own. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, nah, because I only want to say that because I got a cat that live out in North Carolina, right? Yeah. And I ain't go front, bro. Every time I go out there and I link him, we go for drinks, whatever. I'm just like, you look like you came up to Brooklyn and somebody blessed you.
Because it's a lot of those staple stores that have been moving throughout the nation. So it's an opportunity for these guys to get releases. And I don't really per se like that, you know. I think New York should get a certain amount of releases first and then trickle down to the other areas. But, you know, money is money and people will shop it and they're going to buy.
It's true. Shit, that's like, hey, listen, that's like other countries. Like, for instance, Japan, depending on what Air Max, they had a Japanese pair of Air Maxes that only came out of Japan. We couldn't get that.
Yeah, you're right. They just dropped those New Balances, and New Balance only, what release was that? The Belly release.
Yeah.
They only released the Blue ones in Chicago. So, you know, got to respect regional drops as well. And somebody with the blue ones, that's, you know what I mean, it's kind of amazing.
That's fine. That's fine. I ain't going to hold you. Listen, if I see a pair, you know I'm going to let you know.
Lex.
Definitely let you know.
Now, one little hot seat question for you, man.
Talk to me.
Plus size goats.
Uh-huh.
Who is the goat of the plus size lane?
Who is the goat right now in the plus size lane?
Are you here?
That's a tough one. But I'm gonna go back to my first guy. Action Bronson,
man. He's a lot of New Balances as well, man.
Yeah, bro. I ain't going front. Just I'm only going. The only reason why I'm praising him and I'll keep it a buck is definitely because of. Okay, because I'm, like I said, I'm big on the streetwear. This is mainly what I wear every day. Is just streetwear. You know what I'm saying? Even like, for instance, this hoodie. My boy made this hoodie. It's not even, you know, like a Supreme or nothing. My boy made this.
Yeah.
And like, this shit, it's pretty hot. Wait. There we go. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? It's pretty hot. It's all right. It's calm.
So gotta show love all the time, man. Gotta show love.
Gotta show my love. But the reason for the Action Bronson is definitely for the sneaker game, the hat game. You know, some of the pieces that he has. It's serious.
Okay.
It's serious. I you know, go. I don't know if you ever seen it, but do the research. It's pretty fire.
Yeah, no, I fuck with Action. I pay attention to what he's doing, and you know, I see he's been trying to lose weight and all that. He's trying to lead the
Facts. Shit, I got in the gym. Not because of that, but you know what I'm saying. Just for some of his shit, yeah.
Unfortunately, I could say I'm no longer in that lane, man. I'm down to like a large now, bro.
Woo! I'm gonna be there soon, man. Now, listen, I went from a double XL. I'm wearing an XL now, so
health is wealth, my brother. Health.
We getting there, man.
It's wealth, man. Listen, man. We get out of here.
Yes, sir.
Where they can follow you, get some whatever you want to tell them, man. Go ahead, floor is yours.
Everybody that's listening, that's watching, you can follow me at Supreme_EP3. Anybody got any questions or calls, whatever, you can link me there. That's it. Or for any of the big guys, listen, if y'all got questions on y'all want some fire fits, or anybody got questions on sneakers, you just hit me up right there, Supreme_EP3.
That's it. And don't be shy, because we will be posting some of those looks from our man with us today.
That's it.
And make sure what I tell him is either fashion or flashing. Hit him up on his IG.
Let me know straight up what y'all think of my fits. That's it. I'm open to anything.
I'm quick on this cut over here. Hey, let's talk fashion, man. Yo, definitely, I appreciate you for joining us, man.
No doubt.
Till next time. We gonna have you, and we gonna make we're gonna have the update EP, and we gotta go through your closet and see some of these looks that we talking about, man.
Nah, no problem, man. Whenever I'm with it, listen, I'll bring a couple pieces to the studio, and you know, get it popping.
Thanks. All right, appreciate you. Go look.
Now a word from our sponsors.
The JBT Network is coming together for a boxing talk, and I can't wait to invite you to join us. The Boxing Talk will be a fantastic opportunity for us to discuss the latest news, trends, and strategies in the boxing industry. We'll be hearing from some of the most talented and influential people in the sport, including trainers, coaches, and athletes themselves. But that's not all. The JBT Network has an amazing lineup of shows to keep your entertainment throughout the day, starting 8 a.m. with Hardcore Boxing hosted by Jay Hardcore. Then Cast Sports takes over at 2 p.m. to break down the history of boxing. At 4 p.m. the Voice of the Street takes over with Just Do Boxing. The day continues when Hardcore Boxing returns at 8 p.m. and then the night is closed out at 9 p.m. with the Rise podcast The Insiders from the Upton, which is the home gym of Tank Davis. The JBT Network also is the host to Let's Talk Fashion hosted by Remo, where he discusses the culture of fashion, sports, and entertainment every Wednesday at 10 a.m. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to your favorite show. Also, try to share it with a friend.
Now, welcome back, everybody. And you know what time it is. It's your favorite part of the episode. And it's Fashion the Clashing, where we discuss a few looks that we've seen, whether it be Instagram, whether it be the culture, where we discuss whether it's fashion or it's clashing. Fashion meaning is dope. You love what you see. You can put some looks together. Is it emulating something that you will see or in the culture that is winning versus clashing, which is get it out of here. We not feeling it. It ain't dope. For better words, fuck out of here. And let's discuss a few of our looks this week. And why not start with our guest, looks from Colby. Supreme EP3. My man puts his looks together, man. I got to give it a fashion with the rip because he puts together all his looks and he never looks out of place. He never looks like he's flustered. He's not looking or reaching for something that's not in his element. And I definitely like everything I see when it comes to this man's fashion. And funny story is, you know, being that, you know, I was a bigger dude at one point in time. I was like 265 and we seen each other and we was like, yo, who this dude? You think he fly to me? This is my lane. This is big boy fashion, and this is what I do. And, you know, we kind of tip our hat to each other from time to time. So we definitely appreciate what he's putting in together when it comes to the looks and definitely fashion over here. Now, I know we gave Fat Joe some flowers, but sometimes the looks, they change. The times change. The elements of fashion put together, they waver from time to time. And Fat Joe, come on, we got to bring you to the stage, man. This one right here is definitely a clashing. Everything about this look seems uncomfortable. The jacket looks small. The pants look big. The boots look big. No, the pants actually look small. The boots look big. And it's like, it's not really giving Joe, Fat Joe, the flyest that we grew up on. And I'm definitely going to have to give this one a clashing, man. Fat Joe, you know, you the sneaker god. We appreciate you. You know, you from New York, BX the Bronx. But this look right here, it wasn't in our favor, and it might have been voted one of the worst dress looks the last, I believe it was last year. So we definitely going to be clashing on this one. Now we want to highlight some of our Instagram loves that we had, you know, this week. And I want to give a big shout out to, I want to say is Ruse World, R-U-E-S World. She's a female, and I love everything about what she does. So let's get it out the way. She's definitely fashion all the way around. And she really has fun with her fashion. She shows different looks, different feels. And she's bringing a happiness when it comes to fashion. And, you know, really enjoying her moments in fashion. It's very playful. She kind of looks like and feels like she's pulling from that whole Missy Elliot era in the modern 2000s, 2024, that is. But I definitely got a big hug and keep doing your sister. Keep doing your thing, sis. We see it. We appreciate it. And definitely, definitely, definitely fashion, man. We love it. We love to see it. We got one more look. And this is from J Style XL. So you see Plush Size XL is in the name itself. And he kind of broke down his fit step by step. And, you know, when it comes to big boy fashion, you know, it is kind of hard to find confidence in your sizing and the way it actually folds on your body. And sometimes, you know, the confidence waver. But this guy right here, he knocks it out the box. Definitely a fashion in my book, man. And you should follow this guy if you need inspiration, because he really takes his time and he gives you the way he sets up his fits straight from the from head to toe. He takes you step by step throughout his outfit. And he always looks like he's leaving the house in confidence. And y'all should get familiar with him, man. Appreciate you for tapping in with us this week. Don't forget to rate, comment, like, subscribe, share, dislike, whatever you want to do. Until next week's episode, definitely follow us at rich_threads. Hit the subscribe button and cop some merch, man. Until next week. We out of here. Peace.